Hi guys, I'm Joel. Thank you for watching this video. So, Jewels and the Secret Workshop event has started in Otogi, and I'm currently playing it. So, you can see the competition is quite, competitive. Lots of people are playing in there. So, let me talk about the system very quickly. So, if you go and look at the event rules, you'll see it. Wow, there's a effing essay over here, right? So, basically, the easiest thing to understand is that you play the chapter and you get 3 stars. So that basically the more you play, the higher rank you get. And let me play one stage and then you can see approximately. And then at the same time I'll talk about what I think is the rate of production of pyrocene shards, which is the main thing you get in this event, and you get the shards to go and exchange for cards. Basically, that's it. That's the main thing, right? And later I'm going to talk about what cards I prefer as well in this event. But you can see here, so you need to get 3 stars, right? It's a lot better. You get more pyrocene shards, you get a higher score. But because the enemy is kind of weak, so to me, especially in the first chapter, it's really difficult to get a 3-star rating, right? Because the enemy basically just flips over way too quickly. And then so I spent 10 soul essence, and then I got 10 pyrocene shards. So actually, this is around the same rate that you would get in normal as well. So basically, 1 soul essence per pyrocene shard, you could consider it that way. Which brings us to a calculation later, but when I talk about what we can exchange for, right? So, let's look at. So we talked about shards, and so let's look at what kind of things we can exchange for. So the further you go in the chapter, the more you can exchange. For example, I beat chapter 1, I can get a nephrite, which is a 3-star card, and then all these memories are there by default. And I would not recommend using the hard-earned shards to get memories. And then you get 5-star cards, like in, for example, Hermes, and Empress of Uruguay, and then Don Pedro Aquamarine. So these are the cards you should get. You should consider getting. Right, so now let's do some calculations. So I said, according to my observation, it's approximately 1 soul essence per shard, right? So basically, suppose you play this game like for free, like don't use any items, and you play every waking moment, right? Suppose you sleep for 8 hours and then you play every waking moment, right? So approximately 16 hours, right? Because sometimes, because when you wake up, you can play a full soul essence, right? But maybe sometimes you're busy and then you miss a few. So let's pretend it's 16 hours. And then every 5 minutes for 1 essence. So basically, you have 12 soul essence per hour. So every day you get 192, right? And then there are 14 days in this event. And then so you get 2,688, right? So if you remember just now, the 5-star costs 5,000 shards. And then the 4-stars cost 1,000 shards each, right? So basically, this means that if you're a free player and you actually sleep, then you probably cannot get maximum limit break, the 4-star, right? So you probably need to use some items. Although when you beat the chapters with 3 stars and you actually finish the chapters, like all the chapters with 3 stars, you get quite a bit of shards. So I'm leaning towards probably you can, for free, you can probably get 4,000 shards, maybe, give or take. You can use some of the yellow potions to get more shards. And yeah, so I think a 4-star is the realistic reward to go for. So now that we got that out of the way, so for 4-star, what should we get? So we get 2, there's a healer, and then there's an all-attack card. Definitely get the all-attack card. Because in this game, basically, you want to defeat defeat the enemy as quickly as possible, and be able to defeat the enemy using skills. Healers don't help either of these, And also, if it's a kind of boss event where you have to fight a very strong boss, the time limit is a lot shorter than 3 minutes. And then, so you don't really have time to heal your guys. And you should really try to, you should really look for as much damage output as possible. So I would recommend getting this card. And hopefully, if you play diligently enough, then you can get her to maximum limit break. Right, so now let's talk about the ranking rewards and my experience with ranking, right? So first off, I don't want to discourage you, but ranking is extremely hard in this game because it's very, very competitive, it's new, right? And everybody is enthusiastic, and the whole system of this game allows you to play relatively casually and still be able to gain kind of lots of points. Unless you spend money, then that's a different issue. So let's look at the rewards. So the good thing is that this time the reward is a healer, and as I just explained, I do not believe in healers. So probably I wouldn't consider not ranking high as missing out on much, right? And also, it's really hard because you need 5 copies of the rank reward to maximum limit breaker. And you suppose you get to top 300 the first 2 times, you would still need to get a... top 300 the first half and second half, you'll definitely get overall top 300 as well. And then you'll be able to maximum limit breaker, right? Otherwise, it's hard. You can do your calculations on your own, and you need 5 copies, right? It's pretty hard. It's pretty hard, especially without spending money. So that's something you should consider before you decide that, you know, I want to go rank. I mean, this game is extremely competitive, right? So, yeah. So this is it, I guess, and I guess there's not much advice I can give, but the advice is just, you know, try to play as much as possible and don't miss any of your soul essence, basically. And all right, so I guess that's it for my video. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for listening to me, to my opinions. And good luck in the event. And I'll see you guys next time.